Endoscopic submucosal dissection, ESD, is being increasingly used due to its ability for en bloc resection of gastrointestinal lesions. Comparing to endoscopic mucosal resection, ESD is associated with an increased procedure time and increased perforation and bleeding rates due to poor visualization of the dissection plane during dissection. Different ESD auxiliary techniques were described. All aim to mobilize the partially resected lesion, increasing visualization and access to the submucosal space. Most of these techniques are laborious, complex, expensive, and only allow traction of the lesion. The yo-yo technique is a new and simple ESD auxiliary technique. Using conventional endoscopic devices, it allows full mobilization of the partially resected specimen. This technique improves access to the submucosal space, dissection plane, and luminal side of the lesions, enabling safe and accurate ESD. For demonstration of the technique, a case of a patient with a type 2A dysplastic gastric lesion referred for ESD is presented. For lifting, a solution of saline with adrenaline, hydroxypropyl methyl cellulose, and methylene blue is used. As the lifting sign is good, subepithelial injection is continued. A circumferential incision is made outside the dots using dual knife on endocut mode effect 2. In this case, an IT knife 2 is also used, due to the difficult access to the lesion margins and need for retroflexion. A cap is placed in the tip of the endoscope to increase access to the submucosal space. Subepithelial injection is done as needed to increase the submucosal space. We can see that, even using a cap and subepithelial injection, the visualization of the dissection plane is difficult, turning the ESD procedure more prone to bleeding and perforation. In the yo-yo technique, a clip is placed in the appropriate margin of the lesion. Tape is placed in the tip of a snare to avoid mucosal injury. After applying gel, the snare is carefully inserted through the nose using endoscopic guidance. In order to orientate the snare, a foreign body forceps is inserted through the endoscope working channel. With the orientation of the forceps, the clip is grabbed by the snare. Due to the moderate stiffness of the snare, the partially resected lesion can be pulled or pushed, exposing the luminal side and the submucosal space. A tape is used to block the snare handle. In this way, there is no need for an additional operator to control the snare movements. By pulling the snare, the lesion is pulled, uncovering the submucosal space and the dissection plane, turning ESD faster and safer. In case of bleeding, the bleeding vessel can be easily exposed and hemostasis performed. A coag grasper is used with soft coagulation, effect 5, 80 watts. The usefulness of a water jet is also highlighted in this case. With the yo-yo technique, submucosal injection is needed less frequently, turning ESD into a faster procedure. The advantages of this technique are highlighted in this case, where a retroflexion position is needed and access to the submucosal space and luminal side is hampered. With the yo-yo, the full mobilization of the lesion enables fewer and more precise maneuvers of the endoscope and knife. The presence of the clip in the specimen permits a precise anatomico-pathological orientation. Now some cases using the yo-yo technique in different contexts are presented. This is a case of a patient with a dysplastic lesion in the pylorus. In this region, there is a tendency for the partially resected specimen to curl, hiding the submucosal space, or to move inside the duodenum, hampering access to the distal luminal side. The pulling and pushing movements of the snare enable easy access not only to the submucosa, but also to the distal luminal side. In this case, a patient with a type 2A to 2C gastric lesion with high-grade dysplasia was referred for ESD resection. The localization enabled good submucosal visualization, but using the yo-yo technique and pulling the snare, the access to the submucosal space improved. Pushing the snare, the luminal side is displayed, turning ESD to a safer and faster procedure. In this last case, the access to the submucosal space was difficult due to localization of the dysplastic lesion in the antrum posterior wall. Pushing the snare, the submucosa becomes evident, exposing the dissection plane and enabling precise dissection. The yo-yo technique uses conventional endoscopic devices and is easy to set up. Contrary to most of previously described techniques, the yo-yo technique enables the lesions to be pulled and pushed, increasing the access to the submucosal space, dissection plane, and lesion's edges. The yo-yo technique improves ESD accuracy and safety. This technique may be used in different regions of the gastrointestinal tract.